Who's my bee? Don't nobody know my honeybee like me. She don't need beacons of the sea for the ones who need it most. I know each line of the book she reads, she knows the way I like my toes. And if I thought that I was dreaming, I'd wake up each night screaming just to find myself in the arms I love the most. She's my honeybee, sweet taste of honey, got a hold of me, you see. My honeybee knows me. And she's my honeybee, she gives me all the love in the world. Nobody knows my bee. Don't nobody know my honeybee. Nobody knows my honeybee. Nobody knows my honeybee. Why lie me?
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Luke McGuire on the keys. So who's nervous about getting up and playing tonight? Yeah, there's definitely a few nervous faces throughout all right.
Midnight into the
on the keys. My name is Colin Gavin. You'll be wandering around with a few CDs at some point. Feel free to come up and say hello. Guys, give Peter one more round of applause. Enjoy the rest of the show.
Very good results in both guitar and piano this year and last year. Angus, who has been the mainstay he was at the Lock and Key. It was the old Lock and Key, for those of you who remember the Lock and Key. And I think my two daughters, Claire and Robin. Okay, so look, who wants to go first? Keyboard or piano? Do you want to go, Ethan? Okay. All right. Give a big round of applause for Ethan Beaton.
Thank you.
Aoife Whelan, well done Aoife. Gabriel, are you there? Gabriel? Oh, there you are. Next we have Gabriel Rad, and he's going to play piano, and it's called the Galway Piper. Hang on a sec, Gabriel. Galway Piper, Gabriel. Thank you. Okay, I think this is Dara. And you need the music, dude. You need the music. Maple Leaf Rag. Okay, I'm going to sit down for this. So. Dara McCann.
Thank you.
Okay.
I'm going now.
Angus.
I know, it's much a little bit.
I think I'll just wait a few more minutes. You do a number?
Maybe I'm amazed at the way you put me out. Sorry about the kind of baggy piano sound. I told Peter not to buy the piano on Tuttle's, but he wouldn't listen.
My best attempt at a song called Harpies. And I'm going to take that off because it tends to bang against the back of the guitar.
Thank you.
Sorry about the kind of bangy piano sound. I told Peter not to buy the piano in Tuttle's for the open message. Okay, that's another Paul McGarvey tune. Here's something by Jeff Lynn, who is of course the lead singer with that ELO for years and years. This is Mr. Blue Sky. Thank you.
Okay, bass guitarist is just about arriving, and our next performer is the person I mentioned to you, and I've been to you all those years ago. Okay, can I do the hush, please? Okay. Wait, just a minute. Baron, will you just pass that?
Thank you.
Okay, Emily, are you ready? This is Emily McCann, sister of Daryl, who played Maple Leaf. Emily was tagging along many years ago with her older brother Dara. On one occasion, she kind of put her head around the door and she never left. So, we started on keyboard. And so we were doing piano, but wasn't really kind of enamored with it that much. Certainly not the extent that our brother is. And then we doing the British thing, the guitar. Straight in at grade two with very nice results in our exam earlier this month. And then came in with this thing last week. So, rock chick in the making. Okay, so she's going to play something that she did in our exam, and I'm going to accompany you. And the examiner actually took up his ukulele, didn't he? And we had a right there, Louie. Okay, so I have to get my guitar and
Thank you.
Well done, anyway. Okay. Do you want to hear Luke play?
Where do I put your guitar?
Where are you, Luke?
Hello.
Okay.
I'll find it. Where
do you think? Do you want to try the lower end, yeah? Luke is going to play. Was it over? Okay. Okay, you want to do three numbers?
Yeah, we used to live
in...
Yeah,
the son and the daughter. The son lives in... Yeah. And in Aurora.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I hate on it, because
she gave me her... He's a bachelor.
Oh, yeah. That's what he needs to be, so... Yeah, we used to... Well, no, my family still live down there. We used to live down in Meads, down near Trim or Navan. Yeah, we moved up from Swords and moved down there for like, I lived down there for maybe 12 years or something, and then moved back up to Dublin. I like it, it's probably proper countryside as well as down there. I like it, like it's, I enjoyed it while I was there, but then I was like, at the age I was, it was bad. I couldn't do anything, like unless you drove a car, I was too young, and I couldn't drive a car, and just I'd been stuck there. We lived in a Gaeltacht as well, so there was like nothing, there was like I had to walk to like the local shop, it was like maybe 15 minutes, and then all there was a shop and a pub, and that was it, like, you know. And then they all spoke Irish as well. And they call them make it tight. No, I should, do I say the sign?
The sign guys.
He's over there. It makes it sound worse for like the people there before me.
Thank you.
Okay. Wait, just wait. Baron, will you just test that? Put her head around the door and she never left. So we started on the keyboard. And so we were doing piano, but wasn't really kind of enamored with it that much. Certainly not to the extent that our brother is. And then we straight in at grade two with very nice results in our exam area this month. And then came in with this thing last week. So, rock chick in the making. Okay, so she's going to play something that she did in our exam, and I'm going to accompany you. And the examiner actually took up his ukulele, didn't he? And we had a right there, Louie. Okay, so I have to get my guitar and yeah, it was,
you all hear that?
Do you want to hear Luke play?
Where do I put your guitar?
Where are you, Luke?
Hello.
Okay.
I'll find it. Where
do you want to try and put it on?
Yeah.
Yeah. Luke is going to play. Was it over? Okay. Okay, you want to do three numbers?
Thank you.
thanks very much, Luke. I think at this stage I have a presentation to make. We had a first for coming up to music this year. If you just give me 10 seconds and I'll go and get. Just had a gig in Dicker Street, and you're off on tour to the States at the end of the year. But what is most remarkable about his achievement is this. We discussed the syllabus for the particular fellowship that he sat, and we then decided that we would approach it in a certain fashion. And it proved to be the correct approach because I want to read one or two comments. As you know, you get a comment sheet back from the examiner telling you your good points and your not so good points. But situation was a first, and the pinnacle of what the examiner who wrote the syllabus, what he envisaged for the SAS syllabus, which is the one that he, so that is the benchmark for the UK and Ireland. I don't think this is going to be achieved again because he got 100%.
Been even almost as much as my parents have been. The past 12, 13 years studying with Peter have been the most memorable of my entire life. I've spent most of my adult life with Peter, so I've become like his musical son in some respects. And there's only been good times and there's only been good memories, so I just want to say a huge thanks to Pete. Thanks so much.
And there are two more. On the day, I asked the examiner if I could invite two other students, the high grade students, if they could sit in. And I'm sure that's inspired by Colin's performance on the day. And I hope that they will follow in his footsteps. The point that I think should be remembered here is this. Not everyone is put out for the music industry. In fact, you need a certain set of skills that not everybody possesses or cares to. So there are other routes, such as teaching. And there is a dearth of really good teachers in this country. It's not that we don't have the quality, it's just that we don't have the tradition, unfortunately. So there are others who have sat teaching diplomas, and there are others to follow. Now, they may not teach music, they will go into teaching. Dylan, for instance, is history and religion, and okay, so he's well on his way to teaching me. And there is another one over here on the left, Laura, who hopes to go into teaching as well. Okay, so it's a great industry to get into, but I don't recommend it. It's something that I wouldn't engage with, although I have. I'm over 50 years in this business, and it would be ideal if you have the skill set. However, on with the concert. I have the bass guitarist here, and I think Matthew and Tiernan. Okay, hold on a second. Yeah, get your guitars. Get your guitars. And Ryan.
Thank you.
This is Matthew, and he's going to play a slow blues, and he's making the transition from what would be considered semi-classical syllabus into the rock blues. So there's no going back now, Matthew, right? Okay.
Thank you.
Are you ready? Okay. Well done. Okay, as I said, there's no going back. Just lining things a wee bit. This on my left here is Sean B. And further to his left is Stephen. And this is Dylan. And Jake very kindly filled in on drums. And of course, you've met Ames already. So this is an old standard by Leonard Skinner, and it's called Sweet Home Alabama.
This is the piano you didn't buy in Tuttle's, is it?
Yeah. Okay, thank you. Kelly Song Lee together. Okay, you want me to do Always With Me, Always With You? Okay.
Thank you. Thank you. Stand by me.